Hello guys, this is Navin Reddy. In this video, we'll continue the part of singleton design pattern. So in the earlier video, we have talked about how to create a singleton class in which you can create only one object of that class, which simply means is at any point or at any moment, you'll be having only one instance of the class. So to achieve that, just to summarize, we have to create a static object. And then we have to create a private constructor so that we cannot, we cannot create the object explicitly. And then in order to get that instance, we have to use the static method, which is getInstance. Now, if you observe this, so let me find some problem with this example. Now, since this object here, this OBJ is static, which simply means this static object will be created and it will be on memory when the class is loaded. So it becomes your global variable. So even if you are not using this object, it will be there in the memory. So that's the one of the drawback. You know, if this object consumes lots of resources, so if this object is bulky, you know, it's wastage of your memory, it's wastage of your processing power. So this part, this type of object creation in singleton is called as eagerly instance creation. It's because even if you're not using it, it will be created. What if I want to make it lazy? So by default, it is eager. I want to make it lazy. Now, how to make it lazy? So what we can do is, we can create this instance at the time of the calling of getInstance. So what I mean by that is, if I create object of ABC, let me say it says ABC OBJ, and I will say ABC.getInstance, at this moment, I should create this object and I will get it. It should not create this object earlier. So what we can do is, we can just declare this object here, and then we can just come here, and we can say OBJ equal to new ABC. Okay, and then we can simply say return OBJ, right? So by using this concept, we are making this lazy. But hold on. When I say get instance, it will create a new instance and it will return the object. That means if I repeat this line here, so I'm creating two objects now, that means it will call this get instance twice. That simply means it will create two objects. And we have lost the concept of singleton here. So what we can do is, we can just verify. So before creating the object, what we can do is, we can verify. We can say obj equal to null. So using this, we are verifying that, is it the first time we are calling this? Or is it the first time we are creating the instance? If your obj is null, that means we have not created this object earlier. And that means we can just, we are doing this obj once. Let me show you the proof. So if I say in the private constructor, I will say instance created. Okay, so I'll be writing this instance created in private constructor. And let me just remove this if condition just to prove my point. And now if you run this, you can see we are getting instance created two times. But now if I use that if condition, if I'm checking this, and if I run this, you can see it says instance created. So that means if you want to achieve this in lazy format, we have to use this concept here. So we have to create that instance when you're calling this getInstance method. Okay, so the earlier tutorial, we have talked about eager. In this, we have talked about lazy. So is it enough? Is it working now? I will say no. There's one problem. See, by default, we have only one thread, right? So this main is one thread. That means it will execute this thing sequentially, one by one. So it will first execute this get instance, and then it will execute this get instance. At the first point, when you're executing this instance, this is the first time you're calling get instance. That means the OBJ will be null. And since OBJ is null, it will create new instance. And then, when you call this get instance, already we have this object which is initialized, so it will not execute the if part, it will directly return the object. But what if I use a thread concept here, and if I create two threads, one working with OBJ and second working with OBJ1, the problem is both the thread might enter this block at the same time. So both will call this OBJ equal to null, and for both the values it will say, yeah, the object of the value of the object is null, and both the threads will execute this statement. That means this will be executed twice, and that means we are getting two instances. Let me prove my point with this. What I will do is I will just prove this point in the next part of the tutorial.